this comes along our way. Sometimes it is sickness. You've given your life to Jesus, but your mama is sick. Your papa is sick. You yourself are sick. Sickness and sickness everywhere. And that is, it is a trial. It is hard. I know a story right now of a man. He is brilliant when it comes to explaining the Bible. Very good. But he has cancer right now. And we don't understand why. And the doctors have told him you have 2 months to live. And it just doesn't make sense. Sometimes, the worst of them all, death can come. Death can come. So I believe that Paul, in his mind, he wanted the people to understand, because follow me, when you are in a race, you need to exert energy. Am I right? You need to strive. Am I right? I understood that in Paul's mind, when he wanted to communicate the essence of the Christian life, he often chose terms of a warrior or somebody who was in a race. In Ephesians chapter 6, are you familiar? You have the soldier there who has the breastplate and who has this, who has that. In his mind, he thought that the Christian life was one that was not just passive. You had to fight. You had to run. You had to exert energy. Are you understand what I'm trying to say? It's not a passive one. So Paul wanted him to understand that when trials and things come along the way, don't give up. Keep going. Keep running. Continue following. You're knowing that you are not there yet. Keep going. Keep running. Keep fighting. Oh, my friends, understand this. But he that endureth to the end shall be saved. The Christian life, my friends, needs endurance. It needs energy. It needs your effort. Look at this. I want you to notice. This is another passage in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Paul is also using the idea of running in a race. This is what he says. Wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin, which doth so easily beset us, and let us do what? With patience, the race that is set before us. Looking where? Unto Jesus, the what? And the? Of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of God, at the right hand of the throne of God. So Paul says, we are in a race. There are things that we must get rid of. This is what he was actually saying. You cannot run in a race with the bag. Are we together? You cannot run with the bag. You have to throw off the bag. You need to wear shorts and you need to wear good running shoes so you can run freely. And so Paul, in his mind, he's thinking, telling the people, don't allow anything. Please hear me, my friends. Don't allow anything to bring you down, to be heavy on you. So this, understand me, my friends, as I review what I've just told you. Paul was using this idea of running in a race so that, one, he could communicate to the people that Christ is inexhaustible. He is inexhaustible. Paul was trying to communicate to the people. The second point is that their spiritual hazards do not become complacent. And the third thing was, Paul was telling them that you need to be careful that nothing is going to stop you from finishing the race. The Christian life requires endurance. And so, my friends, as I get to the end, follow me. The point is very simple. Being enamored with Christ means knowing the difference between the and the. This is where it counts, my friends. You and myself need to know this clearly. And I believe if you can know this very clearly, you shall be enamored with Christ no matter the circumstances you're facing. no matter the situation. You know why? Because you know that the one who I'm following after is God himself. The one who I'm following after, one day, if I remain faithful, is going to call me up and I'm going to receive the prize. I don't know what he has in store for me, but I know that one day I'm going to receive the prize. And as I end, I just want to read the text one more time. The Bible says, not as though I had already attained, even though we're already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I'm apprehended of Christ Jesus. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, come on, and reaching forth unto those things which are before, what? I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Already and not yet. This is the only way I believe we can be enamored with Jesus on a daily basis. This, I believe, is one of the ways to continue to grow in our relationship of faith with Jesus Christ. You see, my friends, what I'm trying to communicate to us is that we need to develop this mindset of already and not yet. This needs to be the battle cry. I know I pray 5 times a day. That's already. But now I need to pray 6 times. I know I share the faith already. But now I need to share more of my faith. I know I overcame yesterday, but today I need to overcome again. Let me make it very simple as I'm ending. Do you eat every day? You don't say it like you eat every day. Do you eat every day? Do you know that you need to be spiritually fed every day also? Do you know that? Do you know that as you take a bath every day to clean yourself, you need to do the same thing in your spiritual life? Do you know that? This is how simple it is. Knowing that the shower I took yesterday or the food I ate yesterday, the food I ate for lunch is not enough. I need to eat dinner again. Knowing that what I have done is not enough. I need to do more today. I need to do more today. My friends, I want us to make a commitment to the Lord tonight and ask Him to instill this idea in our hearts and ask Him to help us on a daily basis. This, I'm talking to everybody now. To help us on a daily basis to remember, Lord, what I did yesterday doesn't count anymore. Today I need you afresh. Today I need a new power of the Holy Spirit. Today I need you afresh. As we did yesterday, I'm just going to ask us to pray. I'm going to invite my brother Ayers to pray for us. You're going to pray for yourself. And then after that, my brother Ayers will pray as we close. But the commitment that I want us to make to the Lord is very simple. Lord, I want to have a mindset that is already and not yet. I am not satisfied with where I am. I want to grow more in my relationship with you. Every day. Every day. Let us kneel together as we contemplate and we think about these words, and our brother Ayers will pray for us.
for encouraging us, for giving us strength to continue. Thank you for convicting us. Thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit. Father, we come before you this evening. We ask that you forgive our sins, in thoughts, in action, intentionally, and unintentionally, Father. And we plead in Jesus' name to receive the Holy Spirit, so that, Father, we may continue to walk, we may continue to run. And though we are tempted to give up, and as we are tempted to stop, and as the devil discourages us through friends, through family, through different challenges that we face, we ask, Father, that you may continually strengthen us to run and to remain enamored with Christ. Thank you, because he who began a good work in us will finish that work. Thank you, Father, for the gift and for the privilege of knowing you and the forgiveness. Thank you so much, Lord. We pray that at the end of this, we may grow in our journey with Christ. Not only that we may grow, but Father, when we leave and we encounter the trials and difficulties, we may remember this sermon, Father. Thank you for encouraging us to keep running and to endure until the end. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.